had goosebumps and stuff. I was like, hey, this could really be something. Hey guys, Ferry Corsten here. Some of you may know me as System F as well. And this is the story about Out of the Blue. It was by accident that a friend of mine and I, we started making these mixtapes and started selling those. One of those tapes ended up in the hands of a bunch of other guys who had a little studio. After a few weeks of nerding out, we just sat down together and just like started, you know, creating what we thought was sort of cool stuff. Cool thing with Out of the Blue was that I just got the Roland JP-8000, and I believe I was one of the very first in Holland to have that synth. And it was famous for its super saw feature, where you just detune, you know, the various oscillators in the synthesizers to get this really wide sort of beehive type of, you know, synth sound, much bigger and wider than sort of any other sound out there at the time. Experimenting with that synth all the time, and then I, you know, literally that's what the name comes from. Out of the blue, I found the melody, you know, especially when I repeated it with that actual sort of accent note the second time around. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You know, I was like, wow, I had goosebumps and stuff. I was like, hey, this could really be something. I got the melody down first, and then the track built around that really pretty quickly. Growing up in the 80s, basically listening to music and getting my influences from that, Italo dance was really big in the Netherlands. If you listen back to Out of the Blue, there's a lot of the Italo dance influences in there. You know, there's the big synthy stuff, and so that's basically my sort of interpretation of an old Italo record. Out of the Blue was just a really fun story in the sense when, you know, when I had the track done, a friend of mine came in who's usually, you know, at the time was always clubbing, and he was listening to this track, and he's like, dude, I really feel like I'm just on whatever. This track's just like, oh, it's crazy. So I brought it to the label, Tsunami, and we listened to it, and he was just blown away as well. And so instantly we got sort of like the response that the few people around us heard it. Gave us. I was like, we kind of need to do something crazy with this, you know? It shouldn't just do a white label, send it out, and it lands on every A&R's desk and underneath a big pile of other stuff. The promo vinyl of Out of the Blue, we only had like 10 copies or so. One-sided, we scratched out the serial number, so the label couldn't be traced. On the back side, that didn't have any music, it just had engraved sort of like Out of the Blue on it. We put like a ransom letter style sheet with it, Out of the Blue, something to blow your brains out. That's what we sent to like the Tongs and the Juleses and Okies, and you know. So yeah, within 2 days we got like phone calls and stuff, especially from the UK. That was basically where it all happened right away. Pete Tong was just absolutely chasing this track, you know, knowing what he normally plays and then thinking of it was him chasing this track. That for me was just something like, you know, wow, I'm really on someone's radar here, you know? Just Jules, Dave Pierce, all the three guys with the biggest radio shows on Radio 1 at the time were just hammering this track. So, yeah, for me it was just like a dream come true. Why not Ferry Corsten? I get that question a lot. It's simply because at the time it wasn't cool to do something with your own name, especially not having a Dutch name or, you know, a non-English sounding name. At least to me, it didn't feel like that's something that could be a selling point. The F stands for Ferry. system stands for the way I was producing. It was very systematic, so almost like the same sort of procedure in a way of how to build tracks. But because of Out of the Blue, System F became really popular in Japan as well. So I was there all the time, and so came the first album with, you know, Soul on Soul with Mark Helmand, and I did the theme song for Dance Valley. My first track with Armin at the time, Exhale. So yeah, that was a just like a time capsule of a lot of stuff happening, all in a small sort of like time frame, really. Out of the Blue was the one that really started it all for me.